Right, your favourite Geordie, who doesn't quite sound like a Geordie, is back to experience probably more deaths. But one thing I am going to take note of, the last episode was like almost 50 minutes. I didn't quite intend for that. I think it's because I thought I was about to enter a boss arena. It'd be nice to split it, but that wasn't the case. So a certain computer glitch allowed me to get through that and somehow still end up in game. So here I am, after 50 minutes of gameplay. So thank you for those who stuck through. This episode isn't going to be as long as that, you'd be happy to hear. It's going to be between 20 and 30 minutes, that's what I've decided. And unless I'm obviously doing something which genuinely benefits from the longer playtime. Now, I think this is where the game starts really pushing the pedal a bit, and you can expect to really be facing some troubling foes, put it lightly. Let's just sneak up on him. I still don't really have anything to... I mean, he's dead. I mean, that's a good thing, but... yeah, that's about what I can say. Right, let's fight this revenant. He's level 5. I think we're a higher level than that, so we should be okay. Let's bring him out, tire him out by letting him attack. Right, and again. There we go. Perfect. And right. Lovely. Don't swing. Oh. It's okay. I'm confident in this. Seven med sentence. Sorry for those who checked the phones or whatever just then. I had a message come through on my iPad, which I probably need to sort out. Oh god, is it going to kill me? Nope, it's going to poison me, so I can just do that. I do have an antidote, but I do want to see just how much the poison takes, unless I do genuinely need to use the antidote. No, it's got a timer. I can see the thing coming down now. Yeah, I'd rather save that until I'm in a more dire situation. There's a shrine just there, so I think it would be pretty bad to use the antidote. We'll wait for it to go. It does take quite a bit of health off, though. Let's use that. Right. What we got here? We've got Itchybell the Daredevil. Come on then, let's see what you've got. Great. And again. Oh, unlucky foot. Alright, let's go. Oh, don't get cocky, because the next four could just be as hard. I don't look like I'm wearing very tough armor, mind. I know I'm in medium armor, but... that's the big in. Is that big? Oh, that's quite big. No. Look at the icon where, next to where it says LT. So no, it's a sword. But I think it's better than what I've got at the moment. So, yeah, much better. And actually a really, really decent secondary weapon to have. So... that was worth my time. Now, I am ignoring these. I should probably have a look. Titles. Title list. Let's have a look. What have I got? What have I unlocked? I mean, does it mean like I'm partially unlocking them? Because as it stands, nope. I don't see any I've got. Quite one, I'm 50% there, and that's attacked 50 people from behind. Fiend Gutter, 6%, 20%, 48% for the key user. Anything from this list? Oh, there we go. Revenant Slayer. I'll take that. Defeated Revenants 20 times. I'm hitting a butt. Nothing's happening. Did that apply? Or did I just... Where's my dial gone? It's there. How do I get it on? Right, okay. Memories. What is new? Ooh, I've just kind of gone through quite a few. Shooting. Don't really use this. Right. Okie dokie. Equipment weight. Now, this is what I've been talking about in terms of how weight affects, like, when you're rolling and stuff, like stamina. If you're wearing full heavy armor, you've got to expect you're going to be more tired when you come out of that roll. I don't personally roll, I don't think, but that's just an example. So, select status from the status menu. View the weight of your current equipment. The more weight you carry, the more ki will be consumed, and carrying more than your maximum limit will greatly increase the amount of ki consumed. Raise stamina and strength to increase your maximum weight limit. Heavy armor tends to also be very tough, as indicated by its total toughness value. Yep, the higher the value, the less ki will be lost to enemy attacks, referring to people attacking me. Toughness values are divided into three levels, represented in three colors in order of least to greatest. They are yellow, green, and blue. Each level of toughness is more effective than the level below it. Of course, heavier equipment is not always better. Heavy armor offers strong protection, but also makes you less agile, and exceeding your weight limit could make you immobile. So there you go. Living weapon. When the Guardian Spirit and gauge is full, press B and Y. Those from the earlier episode will have saw that happen, and you do pretty much wipe the floor clean once you do that. Triggering a living weapon changes the health gauge and the key gauge into living weapon gauge. As long as the living weapon gauge is active, you are impervious to damage, and your close combat attacks inflict more damage. The living weapon gauge decreases over time, and when enemy attacks land... Oh, that should have been a closing statement. And when enemy attacks land, there we go. Once the gauge is fully depleted, it wears off. While a living weapon is active, press B and Y to perform your garden. Unique skill. Living weapons release energy stored by spirit stones, drawing forth spirits that dwell within them for these spirits' weapons attacks are far stronger than normal. I hope that doesn't mean I lose count of my Amrita. I'm assuming that's different. Pray to shrine, regain health. Use the shrine menu, pray at a shrine room, refill your health, and open the shrine menu. In the shrine menu, you can perform actions such as leveling up, changing guardian spirits, and summoning visitors. Shrines are holy places where gods gather. Properly praying your respects here can ease your burdens. There's nothing there about enemies respawning, mind, which definitely happens. So that's just an additional point. Good armor. Occasionally wander away from their shrines and become lost. Seen this before? The little colourful people. But they're difficult to find, and I've probably missed some. Now, please do comment in the comment section if you know of a... whatever they were called. If you know that I have missed a one that would be worth going back and getting. I would more than happy to go ahead and grab it. Oh. I really struggled with these initially. Like, in the first time I played this game. Not to a far point, mind, but almost at the point where I got up to. I'm not sure why I'm doing so well. I know saying that is a really bad omen, but was that just really bad? Has the game changed? I don't know. I'm saying that as I'm dying, but okay, let me shoot him. There we go. Right, Alexa. I think we can take on Shenbu. Let's go from cut down by rogue, which I assume is that person we just took down. 1, 2, 3. Come on. Follow up. Come on. Don't let yourself open like me. Right, got it. That was a little bit greedy because my health wasn't great, but got him nonetheless. Right, nevertheless. Nonetheless? I think they both work. Right, what's around here? I know there's a baddie. So I've prepared for him. One more. There we go. Off his head. Off with his head. Right, what we got here? Ah. We have a small spirit stone, fantastic, and what's here? Ooh, we have a ladder. We've also got stone. Oh, I can! Oh! Look at me finding secret stuff. That's a first in games. I usually go through the game and miss every single secret thing that there is, but there we go. Oh. And now I can't even get across the buildings. There's probably a bridge or something there. Yeah. Let's just use the bridge and not embarrass ourselves again. Alright, arrows. Something. Something else. Almost. Is there anything nice in there? Nope. I can't see anything. Person who I kind of want to drop down on. What if? Do I need to be up here? Seems to be the way. Oh, there's another ladder there. Oh, there's a door there. But that ladder takes me there. Looks like a good route. And I get a fight then. Yeah, cool. This guy's going down. Oh, look at that. Satisfying as anything. Right. Nope. No fancy secrets this time. Now. You need to be. Actually. Right. Okay. It's not great. You need to be up there to get the ladder down. Ooh. Box. And a pistol. Ah, I hit block. Ah. This is where the excuses start coming. Attack him while he's going. Oh, he killed me! Oh, see? This is where the overconfidence comes in. Interesting. Right, let's go back. I'm noticing I'm getting 5 of the medicines now, as opposed to 3, I think it was before, and I think that's because of the things that I drew back to the shrine, which I can't remember the name of. Oh, don't poison me! I was literally a hit away from killing them as well. Right, you're gonna fight me whilst I'm poisoned. Right. I on easy mode? Is there an easy mode? I'm not sure. Right, anyways, I'm not satisfied with leaving after using two medicines, so let's get them back. I'm hoping by doing that I didn't lose the grave. I don't think I did. Oh, he's got a purple eye. Level 9. Jimmy Danads. Well, Danads, let's have it on. Let's see what we've got. We've got an axe. Yes! How do you like them apples? Ooh, we actually got his armor. Our first epic item. Yes, let's go for that. I'll take that. Life 10, item drop 3.2. So yes, I will miss them, but toughness goes up 93. Let's go down. That's it, like two. Better weight bonus as well. Damage reduction 2.3. Human item drop rate. There's probably a way to. What do you call it? Compare. But I'm not doing so. To be honest, I'm actually quite happy about building up resistances in these sort of games, so we're gonna do that. Now, what we got here? That's better, and it's M. Yes, I do gain. Also, if I'm misunderstanding the weight thing at the top, and I should actually be doing it until it goes from green to whatever, then let me know. I'm just assuming that the lower it is, the better. And by adding this little bit on, it might make moving around a little bit different, but okay. I get some mortar resistance. I do lose some earth. Let's put them on. Let's stop. Delete it, dallying. What else we got? What have I got equipped? That's right. But my toughness goes up. My defensive multiplier goes down. And I'm gonna get them. That's what I'm going to do, and I've got one to review. Right, cool. That's them all done. Right, to be honest, I think I'm just going to go ahead and sell all them. I could really silence this. No, it doesn't recognise my thumbprint. I'm some sort of android. Go, that and then that. Right, that's enough of that. Right, cool. So we have stuff which you've not been playing. I've not been paying attention to. Let's have a look at what that stuff is. That sounds really good for people who are like stuck together, as it says in the the description. I do prefer that. That's the same thing but better. But I've got 10 of them. I'd rather use them first. Right. or never use them because they're a limited use item. And as a result of using them, I will end up in a position where I think that I should have saved it for a better occasion. Lock on. Be careful, because you don't want to catch it. Stay back. Stay back. Learning these enemies. Right, be careful. Could be anybody. Was that the only one to hear footprints there? Footsteps, sorry. Hello. Yes, there we go. Take down this guy. I'm not going to use my... Ooh, I've just realised how low my health is. Wow. This guy at the roof is doing my head in. Oh, look at that. I can dash. Oh. Look at that. And it barely uses any of your stamina. Oh. Right, anyways, right, the thing that I wanted to find out was, does my grave disappear? Oh, should have done the drop down a second. Does my grave disappear after using the... What's there? Yay! I really just want to touch my grave. But I've got... Whoa. Get out. Antidote, that was... Sorry, medicine. Honestly... As far as closeness goes, that, that was really, really close. And we've got this dude. Right, no chance. Right, okay guys, keep an eye on time. There will be a fade out and then a fade back in the next episode. So I hope you join me then, and I'm just going to continue playing. So it's going to be from this spot, and yeah, thank you for joining. Please don't forget to subscribe if you have enjoyed what you've watched, and yeah, please give any feedback in the comments. And don't forget to like the video or dislike it if you didn't like something, and that way we know if what we're putting out is doing the right thing. So yeah, just let us know, and I'll catch you in the next one.